Hi, and welcome to part two of my portrait of Maya. I am on my own tonight, so if you do want to chat or ask any questions, just bear in mind that I might delay, so I will get to you as soon as I can. Where am I? Sorry I'm in the dark a bit. I actually think last time I was drawing, it was a bit sore on my eyes, so I thought digital would be better in the dark. So, this is Maya. She is a 3-year-old black Jaguar based at the Big Cat Sanctuary. Her mother was unable to feed and tend to her needs, so the decision was made. She's described by her caretakers as an intelligent, confident, and affectionate character. And today one of her caretakers told me about how they used to play hide and seek, which I thought was really cute when she was a cub, and she still tries to do it now. And she's a big girl at the fence. So, for those of you who missed it, here's a time lapse of what we did last time, well, what we've done so far. It's one thing I love about digital, I can show you all of this. So yeah, if you've got any questions at all, please don't hesitate to join me in the chat. I cannot see the comments, I can only see the chat box at the side, just so you know. Few facts while that's going. Did you know that jaguars are the largest cat species found in South America and the third largest cat species in the world after tigers and lions? They also have the strongest bite of all big cats, exerting a bite pressure of approximately 1,500 to 2,000 pounds per square inch. And because of that bite power, they actually hunt differently as well. They actually, most big cats will go for the jugular or the throat. Jaguars will go for the skull and just puncture right through. They're normally quite solitary as well, and they only really socialise with each other for breeding purposes, and then they go the separate ways again. Now, most jaguars are actually a similar colour to leopards, and a lot of people confuse them. Leopards are not as big, and their skull's a different shape, and the rosettes on a jaguar, although a similar shape to a leopard, they have little dots in the middle. But Maya is black, and that is due to melanism, and that is basically an overproduction of melanin, which is the pigment that it makes our skin colour the skin colour it is, or your pet's fur, feathers or scales the colour they are. And when you have too much of intensity of a colour, for example, think about painting, the more colours you mix together, you're going to get black. So yeah. Another really cool difference as well, which I showed last time, but just in case you didn't see. Their skull at the top. Oh gosh, it crashed on me. Anyway. Their skull at the top, if you can see the picture on the right, that is their, it comes to like a point. Now all the muscles come off that and lead around to the jaw, and that's what gives them their bite power. That is much larger and more pronounced on the jaguar than it is the leopard. Anyway, let's get drawing. Don't forget as well, We are fundraising for my Africa project, Fair Feathers and Wild Endeavours, which you can find out more information at LippyArt.tv. We are also sharing fundraising today with the Big Cat Sanctuary. So basically, any donations will be split between my projects and their whatever they want. Normally, they do conservation projects and rehabilitation, things like that. Breeding, all sorts, to be honest. And of course, my Conquered project, which is where I take challenges and try to show that just because you live with a physical disability doesn't mean you have to live a restricted life. And we will be carrying that on next year, hopefully, once we're allowed, basically able to go back out. Let's see if I can make the music back today. I would like to thank Bullets and Octane and Zachary Kibbee for allowing me to use their music for this channel. It's nice to paint music, it gives me a bit of sanity, I guess. Music and art just go together so well, don't you think? I can't even think what I was doing then. I've lost my trail of thought. Painting brushes, that's it. Now, because Maya is black, she reflects all kinds of colours from her environment, and I've got to admit, it's a joy to draw and try and capture that. I know she looks kind of tie-dyed at the minute, but it'll gradually take shape, I promise. I'm actually going to pause that music because it's stuttering, and if it's annoying me, it's got to annoy you. So, well, we will draw in silence today, and I'll have it sorted for next time. I am actually a device short right now, so hopefully that'll be fixed at some point because it's broken. Size. Yeah, that's about right. So you'll see me swap a lot between the painting and smudge tool. And the smudge tool is basically like the equivalent of when you add water to a brush. If people do like watercolor painting or inks, it just softens an area or it spreads it out a little bit so it's a bit softer. They're such proud-looking animals, don't you think? Really intense expression. don't forget, for anyone joining us, let us know where you're from and join us in the chat box next to the video. I'm not used to seeing us, it's literally just me today because I don't have anyone to read anything out, so I'm doing it all on my own. Hi! How are you? So for anyone just joining us, Maya is a black Jaguar from the Big Cat Sanctuary, and she is 3 years old. She had to be hand-reared by our keepers because her mother was unable to take care of her and feed her. And anything donated today will be shared with the Big Cat Sanctuary, who are taking care of her. She loves playing hide and seek with her keepers and like a sort of tag game by what she described to me. She's really intelligent, which apparently is very common with Jaguars. They're one of the most intelligent big cat species. Looking really rainbow coloured at the moment, but it's important to get this down so that we can build up from there all the details and things like that. All the colours that are reflecting on her fur, it's important that I keep track of where they are. And this is just all coming from really. It's really important to get the direction of the fur right when you're filling in, regardless of if you're doing digital or traditional. Because if it goes in the wrong direction, if your lines go in the wrong direction, it just doesn't fit in. So you've got to make sure that it helps shape the animal and brings form and also defines the muscles and everything. Ugh. actually visited the big cat sanctuary last year and got to meet Maya. Towards the end, it was towards the end of the day though, and it was raining, so she wasn't quite willing to come to us. But yeah, we did see her in enclosure, and she's a beautiful animal. There's actually a video on my channel. If you look at the Conquered playlist, we actually got to meet all kinds of big cats there. One of my personal favourites as well, aside from Maya, I think had to be like the white lions, because I just didn't expect lions to be that big, I've got to admit. Now, you see them from a distance more often than not when you go to a zoo, and when I was at Big Cat Sanctuary, I was pretty much next to them. And it was like, wow, I never realised. And I've got to say, Maya's huge as well, even though she's only 3. I don't know if there's a weird rumbling, it's actually my dog snoring in the background. Oh, bless her. She actually wedges herself right underneath my chair. One day we might do a live with her and show you some of the training and stuff I've done with her. Gotta say as well, the Apple Pencil is a great tool. I'm not sponsored, just want to make that clear. It's a great tool to use with your mouth. Just want to make that clear. It's a great tool to use with your mouth. Because it's very lightweight. And it's just very comfortable to hold, I've got to admit. It feels like a normal... Well, it feels like a really nice quality pen. And the pressure sensitivity is really impressive. If you're one like me who can't afford the huge Cintiqs and... This is the perfect substitute. I've had for an Apple Pencil. The app I'm using is Procreate, which is so nice to draw with. Like, such a joy. So don't forget, if anybody has any questions at all, whether it's about the animal that I'm drawing, or disability, or just want to write general chit-chat, I don't really care. Get in touch. Any questions at all, I'll answer, as long as you keep it family-friendly. This is a family-friendly channel. Ahem. gotta admit, when I seen the footage on of my face, it looks a little bit like a horror movie, doesn't it, with the lighting? But it is so much easier to draw on a screen. And the beauty of this is, once it's done, my original can be whatever I decide. Well, I have to decide before I start. But yeah, it means, because having to work traditionally, I have a lot of restrictions, like obviously the length of my neck can only reach so far. But when I paint digitally, I can envision these huge pieces and actually make them a reality. Because I'll never have to paint on anything bigger than my screen, but when it's finally produced, it'll be exactly how I imagined it at the size I wanted. Some people are like, well, with digital, what's the difference between the print and the original? Because they're both technically printed. And for me, I differentiate it by, I use a very special type of paper and a special print company who are professionals in the fine art industry. I try and make the original as special as possible. And don't get me wrong, my prints will always be a high standard too. But they won't be displayed or done in the same way as the original. The original will be unique, and it'll only be printed once in that form. Some really nice colours in this file. I don't know if you can see it on your screen or not. I mean, all our monitors are different and all our eyes are different, so the fun thing is, if someone else was drawing this, they might see something completely different to me. And I really love that about art. The fact that just because I see something one way doesn't mean everyone else will see it that way, but at the same time, it gives a glimpse into how someone else sees the world. And the thing is, it doesn't have to be exactly like your reference. You can. I haven't done it exactly like the reference. It will be my own interpretation with my own twist. But she'll still hopefully be recognisable. I always take pride in when people recognise a subject. So like, if a zookeeper can say to me, oh, that's so and so, and they've worked with them, or not either. Yeah, it's a really proud moment for me personally. It means I did my job well. So we will be going back in over some of these colours to put in some of our spots, because I don't know if you can see on your screen, but my photo reference she very clearly has spots on her head and her body, even though she's black. There's like different variations of black. A black Jaguar doesn't mean she actually loses any of her markings. They're just more difficult to see. Another good thing about this app is you can tweak your brushes to anything you want. So just because you start with like a preset doesn't mean you have to use it that way. You can modify it into whatever you need, pretty much. Or you can start from scratch and actually build your own. I don't know about you, but if I tried to do that in real life, another brush would fall apart. So digital in that respect, it's really cool. I could technically make a brush unique to just my purposes. I hope you can see okay. I didn't expect it to appear this dark. There are a lot of reds in there. It's really nice in the contrast with the blue. Now it makes like these nice purple colours. Black Jaguars are at risk in the wild as well. Mostly due to humans as usual, habitat destruction, hunting, things like that. So projects like what the Big Cat Sanctuary do are really important to preserving them in the wild. There's a point when I always confuse myself along this. I lose my organisation. Part of that, I think all digital artists kind of have that, because it's... Before we do digital, we always do... We normally start with traditional, and you don't have things like layers, so when we finally go into digital, we tend to forget, and it takes a while to get used to. Bearing in mind, I haven't actually been doing this that long yet. I only started last year. I've been painting since I was like 2, but I only started to draw last year, that's what I meant. So if anyone's got any questions, feel free to join me in the chat box next to or underneath the video, depending on what you're watching from. At present, I cannot read the comments section because I only have access to one window, but I have to actually faff around with the laptop to see comments because I haven't got anyone to help me read them out. But if you join us on chat, they pop up straight up on my screen. Video, I'll totally respond to any comments there. I always try my best to. So if you're enjoying watching this, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit that bell button so you know when we're next on. And also, after you've watched this, please visit LippyArt.tv, which is the website for this channel. It's got lots of information and pictures and an opportunity to support us there and helps keep this going, hopefully. There are certain parts of a drawing are really hard to do when you talk at the same time, which is why sometimes I go weirdly silent. The only way I can describe it is probably it's a bit like, I know some musicians say it's hard to sing and play at the same time. Talking and drawing at the same time. It's kind of... Yeah, it depends what part you're doing, of course, but some bits are easier than others. You know, kind of, you know. It's looking cool, but it's also kind of looking really trippy at the moment, isn't it? I always find it funny how things take shape in really interesting ways. You're like, well, I didn't expect it to look like that yet. Kind of sounds deaf because I'm the one doing it. You'd think I'd expect certain things, but no, we surprise ourselves all the time. As an artist, we're experimenting. So you're kind of like, what happens if I do this? And then it either looks really good or awful. Well, I think it's starting to look really cool. So yeah, let's have a look at that music. Let's go. Hey, I think the internet's improved a little bit. I might expect too soon. We'll see. I hope this isn't too stuttery for people watching as well, because that really doesn't work, does it? Anywho. Ooh, I'm gonna start with yellow there. Let's get that in. Interesting colour combination. There's a like a mixture of blues and yellows. This is so bouncy, I need to improve. I have to mod it somehow, I think. Excuse me. She's just so beautiful, isn't she? Those eyes, I can't wait to see those eyes. things like that a little bit more. I think painting an animal is probably the most intimate you can get with them. Really get to know them. Especially as well, like, if you start painting from life, which we are actually going to plan doing on some future, we'll work out some logistics. At present, can't physically get outside, but we do have an alternative plan that we're actually going to experiment with, so for that, cause it's going to be interesting. We're actually going to get some live animals involved. Underneath this yellow is a real nice purple shade peeking through. Yeah, painting black or white animals. Really good observational study, really good practice, because there's so not just black, there's so much more to them. Almost most animals like that though, like, we think, oh, that's brown, but we've got so many other colours in there. Don't take the time to look, but it's much more prominent in black or white animals. If you look at a polar bear, for example, they're so not white. They reflect colours from sky and ground and whatever else is around them. Anyone who's got a pet that's black or white, you'll see the same thing. you don't even have to look at wildlife. It's really easy to get really involved with this. Just get carried away. I really should find out some more trendy affection. I don't know a lot about Jaguars. And I seem to have been through all of the information I got within the first 5 minutes of this video. I'll have to over prepare next time. I don't think we'll finish this today, but if you follow LippyArt across Facebook, Instagram or Twitter, I always post on there when I'm going online before I do. At minimum an hour's notice normally. Sometimes a little bit last minute if I randomly decide. At least I didn't start on mute today like I did yesterday, hey? Don't forget, if you've got any questions or just want to ask, well, just want to chat, feel free to chat in the chat box next to the video or below the video if you're, I think. And I will answer all of your questions as long as they're family friendly. It can be about any subject at all. If anyone's watching from any zoos or safari parks or charities, wildlife related, especially odds, really. Feel free to get in touch as well, because we'd like to work with as many of you as possible on this channel. Not only do I want to raise awareness, but I also want to give back as well, so. That's looking really tricky, isn't it? This is one of my favourite brushes, I've got to admit. It's like, you can just drop things in there. Like when you do with a wet brush with watercolours. It's not quite at the detail point or anything, but it's perfect for most purposes. It's always good to look back. Sit back and have a look at the whole picture. And another way to see if it's taking shape is to make it smaller. I'm definitely getting a nice shape. It's that time to start putting some darks in soon. Soon. This more like a saturating. Something like that. Let's try it. Put a little bit of it in here too. more subtle. There's one more, it's not quite working. I have it in here. I love the fact that I can actually do this and go through my life and see which. There we go. This one's the culprit. I'll just blend you in a little bit now. I just love this whole pose, I don't know. The eyes are a bit of a pain to get the right size. It's all about learning more. I think this is the first Jaguar I've ever painted, actually. I'm beginning to get impatient now, so I want to see the spots going in the fair definition. It's like the anticipation. It's important not to rush focus. That's why we're doing it. Speak from experience. Excuse me. Please let me know in the chat or comments what you think of this anyway. I'm really interested to see if you like it. Especially any feedback that's constructive. I never have too much of that. Completely neglected one here. Totally forgot it existed. Signs that were so well, aren't they? Between stage. Yeah, I've got to admit, if I was watching someone else do this, I'd genuinely think that maybe they were high. I'm not, I'm just weird. It's definitely interesting. I keep more of this than the original. Because I quite like the vibrancy of it all, and I know I was going to turn some of it down as I was going to, well, as I'm going to do with more detail, but I don't really do. Because I quite like this bright, vibrant thing I've got going on right now. Beauty of that, isn't it? Of what it's our prerogative to do and change our mind however many times we want. Whatever we feel will make the piece look best. If you've got any questions about how I do things or anything like that as well, feel free to ask, and I'll try to answer those as best I can. I've got to admit, when I'm drawing, I don't always pay attention to how I do it. I will explain to the best of my ability. Anything about the animal as well, I like I like talking about the animals that I paint. Especially when I've met them as well. It's so nice. And it kind of feels like when you've met the animal that you're painting, it kind of feels like you're interacting or talking about a friend. Because painting them gets quite personal. All of the paintings are personal, to be fair. But yeah, there's something special about when you've met them, I think. And Hannah, who took us on our tour, was awesome. She's one of the keepers there, if anyone's visited. See if we can maybe see if she'll tell you a bit more about Maya, because she actually helped raise her. She played quite a key role in it. We're nearly there with the undercoat. One colour. See, game patience, that's good mistakes. Always take time to breathe with it. And too far. See how it's looking at all the lines. Got a nice shape going on. Just neaten up. So once you get your form, it starts to you get to a point where you don't need the lines to define it. In the minute, there will be more guides, but by the end, it probably won't be needed. Okay. And we will go. Bomb block. Because I do think it is in the red spectrum. Excuse me. Right. I have done that already. Drawing tool. Now, one tool I really, really like. And I can find it. Dry ink. And it is very much like painting with a pen that's almost running out, which you think would be a nightmare, but I love sketching with like ballpoint pens that are half run out. There. You can get some really cool fair effects with them. It's a nice dark wash drawing. I just love how it breaks up at the edges because we don't want perfect lines in something like this. I bet this looks so close on a big screen. Noses are not perfectly smooth. They have a texture to them. I love doing the noses. It's such a, I don't know, it's just really pleasing. Excuse me. These dry benefits is really nice for getting fur as well. It's like texture but refining at the same time, it's shaping. And you basically just, it's not like dot work, you space out your fur, the more lighter you want it to appear, and you draw it closer together when you want it to appear darker, which brings the 3D shape. I'm not really sure if you can see what I'm doing in this dark area, but I hope it gives a good idea anyway. If not, you might have to turn the brightness up a little bit on the screen. Reach point here where the fur actually starts to change direction. And that's kind of like the center point. Everything turns outwards from there. As we build up the fur texture, it will hopefully start to take a bit of 3D form on top of the light that we've just done. Just gotta go into the eyes a little bit now, I think. Meeting up. It's all gone. Shake up the noise a little bit more. So for anyone just joining us, this is Maya and she is a black Jaguar. This is what she's looked like so far. And I'm just refining her fur and details now, so if you've got any questions, please join me in the chat box. Oh, hi Sarah. Yeah, my Wi-Fi went down yesterday. It's been driving crazy. I keep setting times to go online and then it just cuts off. So yeah, as I was saying, anybody just joining us, this is Maya and she's 3 years old, based at the Big Cat Sanctuary, and any donations our channel receives during this demonstration, through the duration of painting Maya, definitely won't be finished tonight. I will be sharing them with the Big Cat Sanctuary and the awesome work they do. They are involved in conservation projects, captive breeding programs, reintroduction programs, you name it. This is kind of interesting, this part of this, because you've got the fur going in two very different directions where it meets. I'm just gonna blend that a little bit. And you can get this exact same effect with a watercolour and a ballpoint pen or a drawing pen. Remember, if anyone's enjoying this video, please like, subscribe, and share. It's very much appreciated. Actually appreciate it a lot more than you realize, because I like to set goals. And the more people that follow us and watch us, the more of this we can do, and the more charity fundraising and things like that we can get involved with, which is something I really want to do. I just can't describe how enjoyable it is to use this pencil and how effective it feels. Like, I wasn't expecting this result digitally. I haven't really played with it that much until today. I normally go for the bigger brushes. This is so nice. He got cut off again. Oh, bless you. Yeah, it is typical of KC. One day we'll have good internet. I just hope I'm not breaking up too much. If yesterday was a bit on and off. Mostly off. What do I find is the hardest part of an animal to draw from Lewis? I don't really know. It's quite difficult doing face on things like this, getting the symmetry right. I often find I get the eyes quite odd. Although, to be honest, they're not actually exactly the same if you look at it, but yeah, I find face on things quite difficult. Anatomically, cat's noses, the muzzle bit around the nose, I'd say that was probably the most challenging, but that's only because I'm not used to doing it. I don't get many cat commissions. I get to do more big cats, but pet cats and things like that I struggle with sometimes. But it is just practice. Actually, meeting the animals in real life really helps because, like with Maya, we actually got to observe her for a while, and it really helps you to understand the physiology and how they move and how they carry themselves and all different things like that. The next best thing is, personally for me, taxidermy. Skulls and things like that. I look at quite often. Learning about where the muscles attach and how they move. Excuse me. I bet in this light I look a little bit like a horror movie. It's just easier to see the screen in the dark. I really like being in the dark, it's all better than that. You can't really see the lines I'm doing right now because it's in the darker areas, but they will be important when it's actually on paper because you will be able to notice them a lot more clearly. Well, not a lot more clearly, but you need to know that there's fair texture there. No, I'll probably go over some of these first textures again with a cooler black, because there are some blue blacks in there as well. Do all big cats have manes? From Jimmy. They all have fur on the back of their neck, like hackles, but they can raise up and make themselves look bigger. Dogs have them too. more for like a threat display, but no, I need lions, I think. And actually most males, even tigers, have a thicker kind of ruff around their neck. But I consider lions to have an actual mane more than other species. This one's a female, so she definitely doesn't have a mane. Lewis, who would win between a lion and a tiger in a fight? It's got to be the tiger. They're like so much bigger, and they've got such bigger. They're just, yeah, they're stronger. I'd be surprised if a lion won a tiger in a battle. You'll never find out though, because lions are African and tigers are Asian and Russian and a couple of other places, I think, but definitely not Africa. So a lot of people will mistake Maya here for a panther, and she is definitely not a panther. The word panther actually stems from Latin panthera, I think. It's a scientific name anyway. And that actually means leopard. And she is a jaguar. But the reason that she's black is the same reason that a panther's black. And that is, and it's the same reason you get black people as well. It's because of melanin. In animals we call it melanism. And melanin is skin pigmentation, or fair pigment, well, just general pigmentation really. When you have too much, just like when you use lots of colours in paint, it goes black. And if you have too little, you'll go white, and that's how we get things like albinism. She's also a lot bigger than a leopard. Jaguar is the third largest big cat after lions and tigers. They can't think of any Jaguar questions. Why does the British coat of arms have three lions? I did know that, but I can't remember. I'm sorry, I'll have to look that up at some point and get back to you. I bet Sarah probably knows that one. a Jaguar's bite force is about 2,000 pounds per square inch. They've got really powerful jaws. And the reason for that is because they've got quite a large sagittal crest, which is, if I just get rid of this picture in a minute, it's the point at the top of the skull where that line is. And it gives them quite a pointed looking head if you look at this picture. But all the muscles come from there and they come around the jaw, and it acts like a kind of pulley system, I guess. And they can actually bite through the skulls of other animals rather than like tigers and lions who wrestle and choke their prey, normally going for the jugular, and a tiger's actually can sense pulse in their teeth. Jaguars will just go for the skull and puncture right through the brain. Which is, it takes a lot of power to do. The skull's really thick. Taking my fur in the wrong direction then. Let's turn it sideways a little bit. Jaguars are also known to be one of the most intelligent of the big cat species. They've even been recorded to, arguably, anyway, being used, seen to use tools. Like, you know, like monkeys with sticks getting ants and stuff like that. They don't do that, but yeah, it's very similar. Crocodiles have been seen to do tool use as well. That reminded me of saying sticks. They pretend to be logs and hold twigs and wait for birds to land on them. But they only do it a certain time of the year, and that's when it's nesting season, when the birds are looking for branches. It's very clever. Henry the First. Oh, the lions. Apparently the answer to the three lions is Henry the First had one of his family crest. He married someone whose family had it as their crest. And then Henry the Second married Eleanor of... God, my eyesight is awful. Octane, whose family crest was a lion as well, so that's how we got three lions. Okay then. Three families, all with lions. I didn't expect that as an answer, actually. I thought it'd be something even maybe about how we colonized Africa or something. I don't really know. Or about strength or some kind of symbolism. Not just marriages. It's really interesting. Thank you, sir. Alright, can any of you guess what Maya's favourite game to play with her zookeeper is? I probably mentioned it before, but I don't think you were watching at that point. My guess is, what could a Jaguar's favourite game be? Jerry says football. Lewis says tennis. Sarah says fetch. No, you're all wrong. It's hide and seek. It eventually turned into a sort of stalking game with her keepers as she got older. And she still pounces at the fence when she sees them sometimes. Like, gotcha! Do big cats kill for fun like domestic cats? They normally kill for practice, so the only time you'll really see it is like when parents are training their cubs, they'll bring home something alive so that the cubs can learn how to kill. There is actually a theory with domesticated cats that when they bring home something alive, it's because they're trying to teach you. Or if they bring something back dead even, it's because they don't think you can look after yourself, so they're trying to take care of you. But no, generally there's a purpose. Some animals can get a bit frenzied, like in an enclosed space, I suppose. Wild animals in captivity might, because technically they get fed every day and they don't really need to hunt, but you see them catching starlings and stuff all the time. So it can be a bit of enrichment for them sometimes. But generally, animals kill for a reason. Even if it looks like they're having fun, there's normally a reason behind it. Like I said, cats, it's normally to do with practice and training for bigger things. Not including domestic cats, they do hunt for fun sometimes. It's actually one of the reasons they're quite a big problem for endangered birds. Maya does enjoy stalking her keepers for fun though, so that could be arguably, you know, hunting, I suppose. But in a nice way. Always gotta respect, she's a big animal. Yeah. Oh my god, Pharaoh always takes ages. I hope this isn't like too boring. Just realised I went really silent then. Yeah, she probably does see her keeper as a bit of a toy, I suppose. And her friend. She raised her from being so tiny. Her mother couldn't feed her, so she had to be hand raised. So yeah, she kind of probably sees them both as family and entertainment sometimes. This is actually the one from, if anybody's watched Big Cats in the House, on BBC. She was the cub that he was raising. Also, he, several keepers were raising them, I think. And Hannah was one of them. Who we met. Yep, that's the one. That's where you've seen her. That delayed internet again. Let's see what she looks like so far. Slowly getting there. I reckon it won't take too many days, this one. Yeah, definitely. I think I'm going to call this one a night for tonight because my eyes are actually starting to burn a little bit from the screen. But thank you for watching, and I've really enjoyed it. I hope you have too. So pretty, yeah. Thank you. Right, we'll see you possibly tomorrow, maybe Tuesday. Just check the website or social media, you know where we are. Alright, thanks everyone. Bye.